Okay. So I discovered I've been playing this wrong the whole time, because I was doing what everybody else does on the internet, and you speed the whole time, right? That's how you're supposed to do it. Nope, it's not, actually. Let me show you.
Yeah, usually you hold forward and just run really fast the whole time. But you don't have to do that on the junior jumpers.
Yeah. I was sitting here, okay, so they bounce on the land, but when you get out into the open, you have the speed, right? Well, what if I didn't? And it occurred to me, it's like, wait a minute. I don't have to do this? It wasn't until I got to another level where you just jump every once in a while. I'm like, well, it'd be nice if you could do that on this level. Too bad we can't do it. Did it ever occur to me to even just like do it normal speed on this level? No. And I'm sitting here trying to play this game. Well, if only I didn't have to hold down the forwards button, you know, then it would be easier to navigate back and forth, and I wouldn't have to dink around with trying to hold down the forwards button. And did I ever try it? Ever once did I try it? No, never tried it.
No, you figure, well, you're just going to run out of time, but look at that.
Plenty of time.
The way this stage is set up is it allows you to do this, and you won't actually run out of time.
Yeah.
If you just do it like this, go really slow, you'll always hit the checkpoint.
Yeah, you don't have to hold the forward.
Now the future stages, it'll act up.
Look, you have time to fidget.
Yeah, see that?
That's great, you don't have to go zinging back and forth.
Because stage 3 is a stage where it really kicks it in the butt and gets really difficult. But that's why, because everyone just moves through it really quickly. If you take your time and be patient,
this is
the trick to do.
Super easy. And yeah, okay, fine, it's slow and boring, but, you know, at least you're actually getting
the game. Yeah, at least you'll beat the stage.
You'll beat the stage a lot faster by not trying to speed through it.
Now, in future stages, though, it doesn't allow that.
No, not all the time.
If you sit there and do this, all of a sudden, yep, you ran out of time, too bad.
Yeah, either that or you'll start speeding. Now you just jump, hold the forwards. Now you get a couple of things, you get your rocket, and you get your potion. Now if you go down here, never take the first one. Oh crap, I hit the forwards button. Oh, thank goodness, it didn't mess up my timing. All right. See, just nice and easy.
Yeah, just nice and slow. Just
zip right through. Yeah, and then we hit this pillar, get another life.
Yeah, because like what we were saying before, like when you move fast, it's like anytime you just nudge to the right, he just zings, just flies. So at least here you have a little bit more control.
Yeah, way more control. All right, this is irritating now. Is there anything in these pillars? Oh, yeah.
Your Sonic invincibility lasts 5 seconds, right?
Way worse than Sonic. What I would give for Sonic invincibility. Boy, glad I had this thing. On Sonic, they just distract you with all these twists and turns. It's like,
yeah, Sonic the Hedgehog 2, when you get that invincibility, there are no enemies around to use it on.
Yeah.
So it's like, what's
the point?
Here,
there's tons of enemies, but it takes it away from you, boom, like that. I'd love to snap my fingers right now, but I can't.
Yeah, by the time you get the invincibility, here we go.
Also, I've been fighting the dragons all wrong. I didn't know you could shoot him in the face right away. Look, now he's visible.
Yeah, you've been shooting him in the body.
Yeah, I've been trying to destroy every segment. And that's what I thought you had to do, is destroy every single side. Boom, done. Look at that.
But now you got to fight, what, 3 of them?
I've been sitting here looking. Yeah, that's true. There's more of them. But it's like I've been sitting here trying to destroy them piece by piece, because I thought that's what you're supposed to do. And if you stay on the ground pretty low, for most of them, that works really well. Boom,
oh, wow,
done.
Too?
And then, I don't know, the next one, not so much. It stays more in the middle. Oh, is it this one or the next? I don't know. Now, this one does have a spot in there where there's a life, and you gotta kind of zing over to it. Look out! Look out!
Yeah, I forgot about that.
Stupid hands.
You gotta jump in between the pillars.
I don't know what it is about this game, but every game that I've seen in gameplay footage, it's got that glitch on the right of the screen, where it's like all staticky and stuff. It's like that's not our version, that's like everybody's version.
Yeah, we were playing this game a lot on your console. You got this.
The Retro Entertainment System.
And, yeah,
the colors were way more vibrant than this. And it's weird. I don't know. I think it's your TV or something. The coax or something in your TV. Because...
Now show it. Grandma Linda wants to talk with you.
We should just put this in the video.
Hello? Yeah, we've been playing on your gaming console. We've been playing a lot of this game on your gaming console, the Retro Entertainment Center.
Yeah.
And one thing
And
one thing we've been noticing is that, like, there's a lot of weird glitches that that console has.
Mm-hmm. It keeps, well, this one does. It's designed, the whole game is designed to speed you up and slow you down. But that one keeps making me jump all the time. And on the jump puzzles, that's really screwing everything up and it loses all my lives.
Are you there?
This is another one of those games where it's like memorization. I mean, thank goodness you can hold A and push start.
Yeah.
Because that's what the game is based off of, is, oh, memorize. Like, you have to know to run in between the pillars.
There. Oh, dang, wrong one. I was thinking of an earlier spot. I think I missed the life. Yeah, I think we already missed the last.
And some of the parts too are ridiculous. Like, you'll come out, and then all of a sudden it's like you got to whip really far to the right or the left, and like run in between a pillar. I forgot which stage it actually is, but it did that a couple times.
Where it respawns you, it puts you right in the middle where you have to run the whole time all the way to the right, and sometimes it's impossible to get to it.
Yeah, you can just nail him right in the face. I always said he looked like a panda bear.
No.
Come on. What was it? We gotta fight four or five of them now.
Snowball. Snowball the dragon.
Yeah.
Did you hear they're coming out with a Pete's Dragon movie now?
Yeah.
I remember seeing that as a kid. I had nightmares about it.
Weren't we talking about this guy? He reminds you of Falcor.
Yeah, he reminds me of Falcor.
Never ending story.
Yeah.
The
Greedy World Runner.
The Luck Dragon.
Yeah.
My name is Falcor.
Oh! It's weird in the 3D, it goes behind him and forwards. Because when you put it in the regular, in this version, the way we're seeing it now, he doesn't go behind him and then at him from behind. He just comes right up to him and then he goes away.
Yeah.
It's weird. It's like, why do they have the 3D showing him going behind?
It's like, no, now I gotta be careful because I died once from the boss. Now I gotta be careful where I'm at. Maybe even his tail will hit me now.
Yeah. I always try to stay away from their face or when they get close. Like, you can tell by the shadow that he's on level with them. He's not coming behind them. But, yeah, the 3D shows him getting coming out of the TV and then going back into the TV behind him. I wish we had 3D glasses because that'd be awesome.
Yeah, that'd be really cool.
We could split it into a 3D view for the viewers who have their 3D Google phones. What is that called? Google 3D or whatever?
I'm not sure.
But then we'd have to play it in 3D, and yet we get a headache.
Jack!
Jonathan. Now I forgot this world. What is this? Alright, this is the land of the mushrooms. The Mushroom Kingdom?
Yeah.
Okay. This spot, you have to just get... land right at the hands. Because...
Yeah.
By the time you get to the hands, those heat-sinking blobs, they disappear. So that's great. So as long as you jump and land right at the hands, it doesn't matter if you have to Oh, no! Oh, good. Let me guess, it's just a timer or something. Dang bouncers. I don't need these things. I should just be keeping an eye out for the pillar. Yep. Well, thanks for restoring my time that you wasted. If only, like, most games could do that. That'd be nice. Oh, yeah. Here, you wasted your life on that game. Here, you can get your time back now. Oh, thank you. Get back the 30 minutes it took me to play this game.
I always thought the look of the stage looked really cool. But I always like games that take place at, like, night.
Oh!
I always like games that take place at night.
Yeah.
Always
this one is different.
Night scenes.
What planet is this? Cinco? Cinco. Minus
yeah.
Cinco.
Cinco.
I'm pretty positive that's what it is. Ah!
So right now we are in Tamero.
Tamero.
I think it's World 5, right?
Yeah.
Somewhere in Tamero.
Yep.
You'll need impeccable timing to slip by the hands.
The Chevy Grand Tamero. Maybe it's a Dodge.
Burp.
No!
And it is cool though too, like in here the
filler.
Yeah, get the time because you're almost that your time freezes when you're in a bonus level.
It's really hard to get through this one, so you need that timer because these stupid hands. I mean, the way I've been doing it, I should be fine, but see, it's, they disappear as soon as you get to the hand, which is great.
And it's nice right before you get to the cavern, as you bump into the hand, so you can get knocked back a little bit, so you have time to jump.
Yeah.
Like that.
Yeah, right there.
Jump right on the edge.
Come on! Why do you do that? It does that same crap that it did on mine. It's like, oh, no, I'm gonna pretend you didn't hold it down. It's like, what the heck is that? Okay, I don't know how I got here already, but whatever. Life. I gotta remember there's a life there. Like, I don't remember. How the heck did this happen? It just skipped me ahead. That's weird. Well, that's nice of it. It's like, yeah. Oh, wait, we realized we made a mistake here. Enjoy a free salad on us because we messed up your order. I'm sorry, I skipped over the McDonald's.
Yeah, it does that every once in a while. It acts like there's a ceiling that your character bonks his head on. That's what I hate is those meanie things flying around. I forgot what they're called. I always get them confused because they're green meanies and then blue meanies.
Oh.
And I'm like, no. Yeah. Menacing meanies. But I always say they're green ones and blue ones. I'm like, oh, blue meanie from WWE, huh? WWF, ECW? Yeah.
Get away from me! Ah, they do have a limited run, so if you can outrun them to the side. Dagnabbit! Thank goodness for that hand. Oh, okay, this is the one that sort of stays in the middle. I'm getting them mixed up now.
Wow, a green dragon.
See, he doesn't want to go down to the ground when he's far away from you. He only goes down to the ground when he's up next to you. And that ticks me off, so it's like you gotta stay at eye level now. Yeah, an actual, like, legit scaly dragon.
I do hate it, though, too, that it actually does suck up the time limit fighting these guys.
Yeah, it really does.
It's like, come on. Because then, you got four of them?
Oh, come on! At least he has a pattern like the Windows screensaver.
Alright. Okay. Hopefully you can nail these guys before we run out of time. Oh, yeah, I forgot it actually does reset your time.
Oh, that's nice. That's good. I was going to start rushing and messing everything up. Come on, I hit him in the face several times already. Now he's going to, like, heat-seek me. Boom. Oh, come on. Like, now you hit his neck. Now I have to get slightly above. See? Look at that. You have to stay slightly hovering above. One more. I wish there was some indication as to whether or not you hit him.
It's kind of funny, too, like, fighting a green dragon. In a lot of games, it's like it's rare to see a green dragon. Because I was just playing Dragon Spirit not long ago.
Yeah.
And the dragons that you get are blue dragon or gold dragon.
Wow.
Then you get power-ups, and you turn into, like, a pink dragon, this and that. But the ultimate power-up is the green dragon.
Huh.
It's like, it just seems weird to me. Wouldn't it naturally be a green dragon? Then maybe the ultimate power-up would be you're a gold dragon now?
Yeah, maybe.
Alright, let's see how many times we can die on this stage.
All dragons
6-1. Because this stage, to me, this is that weird one where you have to bounce on the pillars.
Okay, I hear him like... When we got to this stage, this is where I discovered, oh wait, we don't have to zoom forwards. But you can if you want. Just a pain in the butt, sometimes. When I got to the stage, I went, ran between the pillars, and then right over the edge, I'm like, what the heck? I was like, nah, we just didn't feel like finishing the level at this point. We didn't really expect you to get this far.
Yeah, the gap was too big for you to actually jump.
This one speeds you up and slows you down all the time.
Yeah, it did that to me just now. Like, I'm holding forward. Okay, let go so I can slow down. And now he's not. Now he won't do it now.
You have to carefully gauge your jumps and when you stop jumping. Also, every once in a while, there's stuff hidden in these pillars. And I was like, what? A mushroom? Like, what the heck is that doing there? I was like, these are strictly utilitarian pillars. And all of a sudden, they're giving you stuff again.
And you have to, like, hold back.
It's like, you cannot touch forwards or back. When you'll hit the pillars. And you have to hit it, if you want to zing boards, you have to do it at right the right moment.
So apparently we're underwater right now. This is Aqua or something like that.
Oh, really? Weird. Is Aquaman there?
Yeah.
Agua. Someone's got to ask them how they make the fire pillars in the water. I guess they're lava streams.
No, I guess I just can't push forward on that one.
No.
Alright, so I guess I just won't hold forward, huh? I'll just do this.
Yeah, that's what I do. I'm sitting here playing this like, man, I wish I could do this on level 3. Well, too bad.
Oh, right there you gotta push forward.
That's right.
Oh, right there you gotta push forward.
Oh, and remember there's a life right there, too. I don't know if we remembered that this time.
One thing I noticed too, I never noticed it, but looking at the fire pillars, they have like faces on them, like demon faces.
Oh.
Just stare at one of the fire pillars as they're coming by, like the top one.
I guess they kind of do. Yeah, I see another mouth. Oh, it's got one eye. Holy cow. Yeah, that never really helped me.
Like right there. He's just running forward and he won't slow down.
Like, you have to small jump.
It's like this stage is specifically designed for you to memorize it.
Mm-hmm.
Like you have to know when to like slow down specifically.
Ah, there you do have to speed.
Right there, see? Uh-huh. This is that part that makes you whip really far to the right or the left.
And nay nay.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Get some Wex Major in here to whip and nay nay with us.
Yeah, face palms.
And then it's also speeding me up, too.
Yeah. I imagine these are like Mark Zuckerberg's minions.
Great.
Hands. Oh, you never want that. Oh, you could have landed
that.
That's
right. They put those junior jumpers in there because they want you to think, oh, you got to jump on them. You know, it's a junior jumper. You better jump on it. You can't jump on them. It'll just lead you to the middle of a pit.
Everybody's probably ticked at me because I'm eating food while watching the game, talking with my mouth full and everything. I was like, well, if you were...
See, crap like that. What, Spitfire?
Yeah, the backpack and everything brand. What was Spitfire entirely? Is it just a clothing brand kind of thing?
Yeah, it's like wheels, skateboarding wheels and stuff, and just a brand mascot.
Yeah.
I think it was mostly wheels.
Oh, okay.
Spitfire wheels.
Wheels, okay. Spitfire Storm.
Now here's where it gets nuts.
Yeah.
Because all the menacing meaning. And you don't get armor. They refuse to give you armor in
here. Yeah, that's right.
And this is where those menacing meanies just get ridiculous. This is a part I've always had trouble with because you have to like time your jumps perfectly to jump over the menacing meanies.
Balls to the walls.
And you have to try to land just perfect to be able to still jump over the pits.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the pain. When you're trying to jump over an enemy and the edge of the cliff comes and you're still in the air, it's like, ah!
And you still have to concentrate enough to find the pillars to jump in between them. Otherwise, the hands just come up and block you. Well, I just set up a Patreon page. You can go support me. Janitor Jake, Patreon.
Yeah, there you go. Janitor Jake on Patreon.
Like everyone and their grandma has a Patreon page.
Yeah.
Right there. You have to know to hold it so long and then let go because I want to land just past the meanies.
Yeah, I don't recall if I ever beat this level. I don't think I did.
Yeah, the next one was would be World 7, and I don't ever remember World 7.
Yeah.
Because we never made it that far.
Yeah.
It's like during this time of the gameplay, like we already exhausted everything about the game pretty much.
Mm-hmm.
It'd be nice to go into the history of the game and give some facts, but yeah. I don't know anything. Other than the dude's name is supposed to be Jack.
Yeah.
So right there, you have to land right at the front edge.
And jump then right jump,
and then try to land right at the perfect spot beyond the meanies.
That's a pain in the butt.
That's one of my pet peeves when it comes to video gaming, is when someone's playing a game and they just sit there and they laugh like, ah-ha-ha. Just give wrong, like, wrong information about stuff, just completely...
Just completely screw up everything.
And then just laugh about, look at that, those, ah-ha-ha.
Just let his thumb hit you.
Ah-ha-ha.
Well, I was just testing out the jumps here. Politicians. It's that same dismissive attitude. There we go.
Look at, and they followed me too. They're like, "Oh, I'm gonna get you."
Yep.
That's right. I remember I used to make it to that part, and they go, "Now what? Now where's the pillar at?"
There is none. There is no spoon. Alright, creepy child. Wow! Wow, you giving us stuff? Wow!
Now this is confusing because we used to be able to get like the potions.
Mm-hmm.
And we figured the more you get, the more potions you get, then you get more hits. Like I could get hit with this and it'll still leave a potion, but then sometimes it won't.
Hmm. Really?
Remember that? Meanies everywhere. Great.
Shrooms. Nah, you just gotta jump forward.
Oh, that one you can just jump over.
Yeah.
It's like, you can't even tell, though.
No.
Because, like, just this black void.
Yeah.
Doesn't Bubsy have personality? I think it said somewhere at one point, it's like, with personality.
Jeez. Yeah.
What the heck? It didn't even look like he was close to me.
No. I don't know what the heck happened there.
I've jumped in between the pillar! Oh. See, they follow you up.
Yeah, I always zing back and forth because they're always chasing you. And sometimes you get like 5 potions in a row and then it's like they cancel each other out. So it's like you pick up a 1 hit point potion or something like that.
See, now this part I don't know. Do I have to keep jumping on pillars or...
No.
Or what?
Just keep zinging through them. Oh.
I mean, like, do I have to jump over more gaps?
Now, for all I know, it probably replaced your, like, 5 hit point potion with a 1 hit point potion.
See?
And took away your hit points. Look at that garbage. Bull crap.
Well, because the laser gun, you know, that...
Don't forget the pillar.
That does so much damage.
There's nothing in it? That is cheap. That is really cheap. Zings right through it. It's like, no, when you want to avoid it and zing right past it, no, you don't. It's like, no, you're on the same level as it, even though you took time to travel to the left.
I've never made it this far, so I don't know what the heck is going on.
I don't know. I've never seen this before.
I'm worried about, like, running into, like, big, giant gaps.
Whoa, did you hear that?
Yeah.
Now it's all glitching out. Bwap.
Just meanies. Wow!
Wow.
Never been this far before. Look how fast
he is. Cyclops. I always forget the word Cyclops. I'm really surprised that I remembered it because I'm always wanting to call them Monoculuses. Look at that Monoculus. Stupid. Oculus Rift? Yeah.
Man,
he turned fuzzy. It's like you're shooting at him, all of a sudden he's like a puffy cloud now. Wow, green. Sweet.
Alright. Please reset my timer. Okay. Thank you.
Pistachio pudding or whatever it is, a pecan pie, whatever that. That's what that green reminds me of when he turns green. Right now he looks like a sports team. Yellow and blue?
No. The Gators
Maybe
or something?
It's the Gators, yeah, orange and blue. Hey, go Gators!
It's like I want to hit him in the face, I'm just worried that his tail's gonna hit me. And it's like, I think I got it lined up and he doesn't hit him in the face.
There we go.
Alright.
As soon as you hit him and then all of a sudden it turns into the sparks that zing back and forth, I think it's gonna, like, the sparks are gonna just knock you off the screen.
It'll probably kill you on the next...
On the last level?
Yeah, on the final level.
Like, oh, they're lethal now. Yeah, that's right. Lethal. I just said lethal. I'm Cockney now. Well, you got a lethal dragon there, you do. Whatever, that was terrible. I apologize to everyone in England.
Come on. There we go. One more.
Oh, really?
It's like, no, it's like a Nightmare on Elm Street, just faster and faster.
This is ironic to have a 3D game where your enemy only has one eye. I mean, we're not playing 3D right now. Hey, if you switch it to 3D mode, does he have two eyes?
Two heads.
Two heads, yeah. One day we're going to just sit down and we're going to play this in 3D.
Finally.
Oh, man.
Better
now
get
I get
ready.
To F it up for you.
But well, just remember to hold A and hit start.
What?
This level looks pretty cool. Never been here before.
Yeah.
So remember, if you die, hold A and push start.
A and start. Okay, which one's start? Because I see a bunch of, like, happy birthday stuff all over here. I just want to make sure Well, you know what, here. Okay, that's select, that's start. All right, just making sure. All right. Jumping, holy crap, it starts you off zinging super fast. Like, that's not, what the? Okay, A, that's A, right?
Yeah.
Making sure, because it's been a while since I played this. Look how fast that's going. It's like, no freaking way. Nope. Even Kevin Connor would suck at this.
It's almost kind of messing with my eyes.
Yeah. Look at that. There's like a flower shower over there. What the heck is that?
So right now we are in Invinso.
Invinso?
I-N-V-I-N-S-O. So, Invinso. Some enemies here are so strong they can't be killed with your laser missiles. I just really hope we don't have to jump over giant gaps. Holy smoke.
Oh, that was so close. Ah! I was just thinking, man, it would be awesome if I got through this without dying. That's when you know you're gonna die. Like, crap!
And of course, look at that. Now we got a pentagram in the background.
Oh, crap!
Pentagram, a one-eyed dragon. He's down there flashing the devil horns. What is next? Where's 666 at?
Yeah. Oh!
It's nice that you got that.
Crap! I can hate you!
So those were demon diamonds, and those are indestructible.
That's why this level's called Indestructo, eh?
Invinso.
Yeah, that's right.
Invincible, apparently. And it's a demon. Oh, demons. Pentagram.
Oh!
One-eyed dragon.
You cannot slow down. It won't let you.
Illuminati.
Yeah.
Secret societies. Rock. Luciferianism.
Right next to the balloon. Oh, too bad you missed it. Right off. Right off the bat. Now I gotta keep track so I can... Oh! Son of a bun. Get out of my face, you fly.
No, there is a 666. See the cloud?
Yeah.
See it? Six. Six, and then over to the right is another six.
I thought that was like a puff of marijuana or something. What? I picked up a... Oh!
Okay, well, at least you're already on 7-3.
Hey! I did not hit the jump button there. Now it's doing that crap to me. They go, what? Jump? Oh! Gotta get a little look out for that. Oh, crap, I was trying to hit the button.
Thing.
Oh, crud!
So that's the problem with the game. It's like, this already is, in and of itself, is challenging enough. But then they throw all, like, the menacing meanies and the demon diamonds flying everywhere, and it's like, you can't, like...
Oh, man.
Holy.
Whoa! What? Did I make it? Holy crap! Now time to get my butt handed to me. Oh, a little cute little teddy bear, right? Man, he's so friggin' long. It's like, no, he's just gonna whip me with my tail, his tail the entire friggin' time. It is. Oh yeah, okay, he's working his way over to the side here. Oh wow, I hit him once. Are you kidding me?
Into that.
Oh, are you serious? Are you fucking serious?
All right, get the balloon.
I'm trying to get right for his... Oh, are you shitting me? I'm just so angry at this game. And now it's done.
Three long.
Oh! I'm like watching for the gaps and I don't see the pillars. It's like I just physically cannot see the pillars. Oh, son of a gun. Oh, I land right on it. Like, why did you ever replace McGruff the Crime Dog? That's what I want to know. Shoot him! Son of a bitch, I'm gonna run out of time. Sorry. Pardon my language. Sorry, everybody. But usually he just walks right through my shots and hits me right in the face with his face. Oh, for crying out loud, I missed the tail. I should have gone up. I should have just gone up and over him. He's like, no, that's the only place that I have to go. Messing everything up.
Yeah, it's like you just gotta like, it's ridiculous. You just gotta pound away on that fire button. But yeah, it's like every time he loops through, his tail's gonna hit you. You know, too bad. Tail got you.
Then when it's just his face, it's not any easier.
Yeah, because he'll also whip around really quick too and get you. And the depth is like goofy.
Yeah,
it almost feels off. It's like you can't tell. Like when he hits the screen, theoretically, it's like he's behind you now.
That's what it seems like.
All right. See, and then it does that where it's like now you just can't hit him.
Up and down all the time.
All right, so this is dragon number 3. All right, you're halfway down on time. See, that's the problem. It's like it's so much of this weird zigzag, and it's like you can't seem to hit him.
Yeah, and he keeps changing up his patterns. Like, now I'm going to start going up and down. It's like he wasn't doing that so much last time. I think it's rotating.
Oh.
Man, he almost got me. Freaking Jolly Green Giant.
Okay, now we got number 4.
Serious?
I mean, I think there's going to be 6 of them. All right, so you're half timed. So we just got to concentrate really hard.
Now it's gonna take a million hits. It's like, oh, I got plenty of time. It's like, no, you really don't.
Yeah, now you're almost out of time.
It's like, why is it counting down so fast, and why won't he die?
Shoot.
Oh!
One more. Holy smoke,
no,
you don't?
It's done. What?
Okay, I've never been here. This looks cool. Like a big city.
Man, that's cool. Freaking spaceships. Oh, this is awesome. You see that pillar? That's freaking cool. Oh,
okay, so
gotta
I gotta
jump on the fire
jump
pillars?
On them.
That's a pain. And you're Cincinnati. No.
This does look really cool. Yeah, and the pillars are all goofy.
What am I thinking of? No.
That's what it wants you to do.
Get the invincibility and then try to jump on that
I
thing?
Guess. Holy smoke.
What a
Alright.
I was trying to say Seattle. Looks like Seattle with the freaking.
Now I can't, like. He's doing all this whipping around nonsense.
It's almost like it's too fast. It's like coming at you really fast.
I think it is. I'm just gonna try to jump over the. Thingamajigger ones. No, you have to. You have to jump on the...
And you have to be on the right pillar, too. So I would not want to do any skipping around.
Right there. See, oh. it's like he jumps over it.
Yeah.
He's, like, doing weird things now.
But he hit the jump, but I heard him bounce.
Yeah, and it's like, nope.
It's like the
I'm holding
wrong.
Down. I'm holding down, too.
Yeah.
So he should be doing that backed up thing.
Yeah.
But he's not doing it.
Yeah, because it's zinging you forwards. That's why. It's like, no, you have to get the timing perfectly right. I would jump on the square just before it. Square away, or maybe two squares away, I don't know. It's like you have to measure your steps now. I think two squares is about right. No kidding.
Too early.
It's funny. Oh, she didn't like it, so I had to go back to the drawing board. It's like, oh, it's futuristic world. They gotta have blimps. What's this planet called? There we go. Stay put. Fino? Just hold on the button.
Fino.
Does that mean it's the last level?
Ah. Yeah, this should be the last level. And it's speeding me up.
Must be like written in fine print. That would be like in these big definitions pages. Medicine meanies, mushrooms. Restart, speed up, move left or right. Nope, that's it. That's the entire manual. Like, where the heck are the levels? It's like one of those things, like you go back and forth. It's like, no, it just disappeared. I hate it when that happens. Like, whether you're editing a video.
Oh, there's a life.
Nice.
I jumped too early. Oh, wow, he made it.
Wow. Oh.
But there you jumped too early.
Held it too long.
Nice moon.
Jumped too long. Yeah.
It's like, no, that's the sun's shadow. It's just that narrow. It's like an oblong planet.
Yeah, it's our, the sun's casting a shadow on the moon. It's such a weird, that'd be weird.
We thought the last one was big time memorization. Nope, this one is. So I had to remember, come down right now. Okay, now run. So one gap, two gap, three, four, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Okay. 5 has the life.
Whoa, hands. Wow. It's because I'm expecting these little gaps to come up, so then I let go too early. Mm. One of them, there's a life in it.
Yeah, I don't know which one. No, it's glitching out. Like, we don't know what's going on. No.
Alright. Come on now.
I would have hit that pillar. Jeez.
And now, they're chasing me.
What are those things called?
But it's a thing, like, I'm assuming that there's one pillar.
Oh.
So what's where at? Kind of by the blimp, on the right-hand side of the blimp. All right.
By that lonely...
Between the moon, the blimp.
There, that thing with the... I think they got one of those in New York, too.
I hit jump! And he just doesn't do it. Like, oh, psh, too bad. It didn't register. Didn't register in time. Tough. It's like, no, you just got to know to skip that life. Mm-hmm. Like, just don't even go for it. Skip it. All right, so I know I need to stay by the pillars, but... Oh, it wants me to jump on the pillars.
What if you just avoid that strip entirely and just jump over the hands? Do the hands jump up and down, or they just slide?
Yeah, they jump up and down. That's what I was saying. It's irritating because it's like... The hands will jump up and down and smack me, and I'm going to get hit by the demon diamonds or whatever. See, I have to...
You could just zigzag back and forth through that gauntlet in there. Just stay with the hands... And wait for your timing. There we go. Yeah. So land on the sides and then jump up through the middle.
Holy
the heck are those
crap.
Televisions? Holy crap. Now I don't know what those things are walking back and forth.
There is a weird television enemy in there.
Yeah, it's Mean TV, a deadly piece of video technology. Blast it.
Yeah, okay, I'll blast it. Thank you for giving me weapons to blast it with.
Blast it. I'm not going to give you a gun, but you know. Maybe it's cursing. It's like, oh, blast it! Dang TVs. I said that at work once. I was working on something and I accidentally cleared out a section I didn't want to clear out on the computer. I was like, oh, blast. And the guy I was with was like, did you just swear? Because apparently that's a swear word somewhere.
What did I hit?
Yeah, that guy kind of swooped up from the side and smacked you in the side.
Oh,
shouldn't have gotten right.
I was like, oh, a pillar, I better pillar. Move.
Yeah, I know how that goes.
It's like your hitbox is bigger than your actual character.
Yeah.
Yeah, either right on point or even smaller, so that, like...
Oh, it gives you a little forgiveness room.
Yeah, it has a little... And then other times, the collision boxes are just way too big. And so, like, the enemies won't even be close... Won't even actually touch your character, and yet it'll still do damage to you.
Yeah. Like, one pixel touching, like, that's just too much. It's like... It's like you really expect me to believe that the dangerous part of this creature hit me just because his toe touched my toe? It's like, that's frustrating. Nice. Very nice.
Great.
TVs everywhere.
It's like, oh, psh, yeah. You can, a bunch of, I have no idea where what's going on. I don't want to be jumping. See, I don't want to jump too much because you know what's going to happen. Here comes a gap.
Yeah. At least you're back here. Got enough lives. Ooh. I wonder if there's stuff in those pillars.
I tried rushing to that one, but it's like, you're going too fast. Mm-hmm. Bam.
Oh.
See, those ones follow you.
At least they disappear fast. It's like they can't, you're rushing so fast they can't keep up. Bam!
It's like, wham! Yeah, that's a medium one.
I wish I could take a break to, oh no.
I hit A and push start!
What the?
I did, I hit A and push start.
Ah, I believe you.
I was like.
I didn't want to hear you. So close. Well, we'll get it memorized yet.
Like I was saying before, though, I really do like the background. It's like awesome cityscape going on back there.
Yeah. That thing
reminds me of an old Popeye cartoon where he goes to space.
Oh.
I don't know if it's supposed to be in the future, but Wimpy's up there and ordering a hamburger. I will gladly pay you next Tuesday for a hamburger today.
What?
Will that even matter? Pfft, no.
Probably erase a really good one.
See? Oh. They follow right up to me.
Felt like being generous, I guess.
Yeah.
Nope, guess not.
Not no more now. That's right, on the pillars. Oh wow, am I here?
No.
Now where are the pillars?
Ooh, right in your face.
It's because I had to move around. That's right. See? That's right. It's like we have to write notes. Mm-hmm. When I get to the pillar, watch the small jump. Watch the little jump.
Yeah, little jump.
Small jump, right? Right.
Oh.
That's such a goofy jump. It's like, it's really long. It's like, oh, never mind, bam.
Yeah.
It is. That's a screwball. It's not even like medium. It's like...
Super weird. People love new languages. So it's like, I think people would eat it all up. It's like,
one,
oh, I have to 1, 000, learn something
2,
new.
1,000, 3, 1,000, 4, 1,000, 5, 1,000, 6, 1,000, 7, 1. There we go.
All
right, now where's the pillars? Here we go. If I don't get whacked. Okay. Way over there!
Oh.
Can you even make it? Psh, no.
Won't even let you jump.
I even did the pause. Like, okay, pause it so we can find it real quick, right? Pause it. Where is it? It's right in front of... It's between the moon and the big...
I think it's the right,
The rotating restaurant.
Oh, right. You gotta look for the pillars.
I gotta remember the small jump, too. No, the goofy jump. right there. What the heck am I supposed to do?
I don't know.
Like, if I let go, he's just gonna act like he has a ceiling and fall right down. That was lucky.
Yeah, you yakking your mouth off.
Right there, I don't know what to do. I let go, and he's just like... I let go, and he's just like...
You gotta stop. It's weird, because you can't... It's like it's going so fast. By the time you see it, it can't... Because usually I'm gauging, like, oh, I see it, now I'm gonna let go of the button so I land on it. But at that time, it's a slower fast. This is a faster fast, so by the time you see it, you're already gonna zing over it. It's like you almost have to know to, like, okay, I'm gonna let off the button way early this time. So it looks like I'm gonna fall right into the water, right into the cliff. But you're not.
I need to count. How many seconds do I hold on to the button?
I think you just get up to the moon height. Get up to moon height and you should be good. There, stop.
I had to do the same thing with that one too.
Looks like a little shorter jump, so it's like stop at the top of the blue tower height. Oh, what?
Oh.
Son of a gun.
I need to follow the pillars.
Slip batching.
Don't jump on your own.
Right.
So I gotta go to the right. It's like, okay, I have to do the pause thing. I have to like sit here and...
That'll help.
Holy smokes!
Wow!
But I'm gonna die on this guy though, I'll tell you that. See the final boss? No, he's not the final boss. Why would he be? I have to fight 6 versions of this guy.
Probably. No, you have to fight them all now.
Wow.
I figured 6 versions of him and then. I knew it. I knew that would happen.
Wow, we made it twice! Good thing they put that checkpoint so close.
Yeah. It like glitches out and I can't see where he's coming from.
No.
It's like, where the heck is he? Now he's targeting me! He's like, I'm moving and he's doing that towards me, coming right towards me. Yeah, it's like, it's too much of that stupid Nintendo glitchy nonsense where it's like, you can't see him.
Yeah.
Come on, hit him!
It's like something I've seen before. Like a character from something.
Wow!
So, another one.
Like I said, I think it was probably like 5 of them or 6.
Yeah. There you go.
Oh, man.
Holy cow. Still another one?
Yeah, like I said, I think there's going to be like 6 of them.
Another one? Holy cow!
Camera hears all this.
Probably does.
Hears this more than the actual game. Okay, this is number one, right? It's the first guy. Second guy. Just can't talk. You can't talk to the top.
He's jacking.
Alright. Here's number 3.
Sometimes I feel like, oh, our testing computers can handle it. Our best computers in the world are testing supercomputers. They can handle it. So other people's ordinary home computers, they can handle it fine too, right? And your Nintendo, what the frack?
Now the game is going to glitch out.
It's going to appear right in front of your face.
Okay. I think one more. Probably 2 more after this guy. 1 more after him. Hopefully 1 more. Maybe 2 more.
I wish there was a more prominent sound when I hit them in the face.
Yeah. Some kind of an explosion kind of thing.
He's going slightly behind him. Ever so slightly. It's like, no, this one, they specifically want you to blow up his tail. Holy
smoke. Oh, wow, what?
No way. Now let's see, who do we have to fight? Get ready. Is this Grax? What's gonna happen? Do I have to play?
Square says. What?
Babbing away. What is going on? Like, I bet you this is another game. I'm supposed to be. Try what? Try hard mode?
Try what? This is gonna take forever. If you hit a button, it's all just gonna disappear.
They better not say hard mode.
Press B. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Press B now? Or do I want to wait?
Press B 4 times.
Aha!
Aha! Aha what? When?
For the real boss.
What the heck is going on? Hold.
Press B 4 times. Hold.
Hold what? Gotcha.
Do you have a pen to write
it? We're recording it, so.
Press B 4 times. Hold.
Lift up. Lift and
left. Left and up.
And?
1, 2, 3, 4. Left and up. I bet you it is. It's hard mode.
Start.
Sure. So B 4 times left and up and then hit start. Now who's this?
Last guy.
Good luck.
Good luck? Thanks. B, left, up, start.
Left and up.
Left and up, start. Credits now?
See you again.
Okay. This was like some sort of crazy end credits sequence at the very end of the movie, where we're supposed to be seeing the lead actors' names.
The end.
But so there's no credits.
I think we beat the game.
I think so, too. I'm really curious what the heck that... Are we supposed to do it now, or...?
I'm gonna wait, like, 10 seconds. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, nothing. So I'm gonna hit B 4 times.
Hold, left, up, and start.
So nothing. So that's the end of the game. So maybe it wants us to do it like...
I don't know, let me try that.
The manual didn't say anything. Go ahead, you can try it. I'll look in the manual to see if it says anything about that. If I hit reset...
Unless it's completely busted. Nope.
So I'll shut it off, turn it back on. I did.
Take your finger out.
Okay.
That's weird. Are you invincible now or what?
I don't know what.
Or did it just start?
Could be hard mode. I don't know what's going on here. It just looks like normal. It's extraordinarily slow.
Yeah, because
it feels
that way.
I'm so used
to it.
Try
running into an enemy.
I mean, I'll probably die.
Wait, did it?
I mean, it took away
a
life.
Yeah, it took away a life, yeah. I'm just saying. No? Okay, so maybe it didn't do it right. Let's try it again.
All right. I think you have to wait for the press start screen. All so right.
B B B B, start.
Now hit start again.
I don't know what it. All right, that was the 3D Battles of World Runner.
Finally done.
Or, as everyone else likes to call it, 3D World Runner.
3D World Runner.
Holy mackerel.
Yeah.
That was a tough game.
You think?
I don't know how long we played it for, but we played
too
it for
long.
A long time. I mean, we played it originally when we started playing it.
Yeah.
Fine. And then we took a break, mm-hmm. and we had it, and I was working. We were working on a film studio at your place, and we played it over
there.
We
took a break and played it, like, for about an hour or two.
And, man, playing it here, I don't know, it must have taken us, I would say, about maybe 6 to 7 hours to beat it.
I think so.
It's a game of memorization. Like, at the beginning, it's not bad. Once you get to World 3, pow, right in your face, the toughness begins.
Well, you know, there's some easier ways of doing it. Like I showed you, you know, I didn't have to be speeding through it. Like, I thought it was super difficult, and I was making everything difficult for myself. But at the end of the level, yeah, you're right. Like, all it just ramps right up to into, like, all the baddies everywhere. Just da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
Yeah.
Sinking.
It's like playing Mortal Kombat. You know, you can pick very easy, medium, hard, very hard, or whatever.
Yeah.
It's like it starts off on very easy, not too bad, and then you get to, like, you know, World 4, and all of a sudden it just jumps right to very hard. It's like there's no gradual ramp up into it, which is ridiculous. But, and the very end, with the ending is actually kind of unique. All the dragons come out and tell you this code.
That's
kind of
cool. I liked it.
I found out that the code is just a hard mode code.
Yeah.
You put it in for the hard mode. But, as far as I know, there is no, like, extra boss at the end.
Nothing else.
Because I know, like, in Turtles in Time, you can play it on easy.
Yeah.
And then you get, like, the bad ending. And mm-hmm. to get the good ending, you play it on hard mode.
Yeah, now try playing it for real.
Yeah.
And then you also have Tiny Tank, where you only get halfway through it on easy. And it's like, now play it for real.
Yeah.
Play it on medium.
Get the
so
actual
you can get
ending.
The actual ending.
But apparently this is the actual ending.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like Super Mario Brothers, where when you beat it, you can hold B or whatever and push start, and you continue the game.
Just a bit faster.
Yeah, it's a bit faster. Enemies are
like,
whatever.
We couldn't notice that it was a bit faster because, well,
we were so used to the end being like this.
It was so slow after playing the end.
Yeah, playing the final levels, it's so quick when you start over, it's like slow down mode.
Yeah.
But otherwise, 3D World Runner, I enjoyed it. For what it was.
It was hard, but
it
was fun.
The music in there is very catchy, but it doesn't switch up.
No.
Just the music, and then you got the bonus level and the boss battle.
I had to make it more entertaining for myself by imagining different variations of the song.
Yeah.
Mostly orchestral, cinematic versions.
But the colors in here are great. I love it. It's such a super-duper colorful game.
Yeah.
And the backgrounds are really cool, like, to see all the different stuff.
I like their backgrounds and their levels and the colors and everything. It's really neat.
I actually really enjoy the final level, the eighth level. It just looks really cool, that cityscape.
Yeah.
I always enjoyed the way that looked.
I really did like the 3D aspect of it, you know, being able to side-scroll and everything like that, moving forwards instead of along the sideways and everything like that. It's really neat that you can move in, you know, up, down, left, right, and forwards and backwards.
Yeah.
It's really cool the way they did it and the way everything appears. Some things are kind of glitchy the way it appears, and there's some glitches on the screen, too.
And even with the gameplay itself, I don't know if they purposefully did that in the game, but, you know, you start off. He just automatically runs. Don't push anything. You push up, he'll run faster. You push down, he slows down.
I think they did it on purpose.
But then there are times where it's like you don't touch anything, and he's just go.
Mm-hmm.
And then all of a sudden he'll stop and revert back to normal.
Slow back down
It's
again.
Like, what are you doing?
No matter what console we played in, it does that. And I think it's on purpose. It's like just to mess with
you. Just to screw with
you. It's the wind. The wind blew him.
Yeah, the wind's blowing and sometimes stuff.
A current caught him in the water.
So whatever. 3D World Runner, like I said, I think it's a good game, but it's really difficult to beat.
None of their enemies really look like the way they do in the manual.
No, but everything's moving so fast you can't even really tell what's going on.
Yeah.
All right, now as far as the price goes,
mm-hmm.
if you get the game loose, it goes for about $5. For me, it's about $3. Mm-hmm. So if you see it for $3, you can get it for $3. If you want it complete, it's $20.
Mm-hmm.
So, do you think the gameplay is worth $5.
If I saw it today in a game store, still reeling from the frustration of having played it, I wouldn't buy it.
Yeah.
But thinking of like years from now, nostalgia-wise, I think I'll want to have a copy of it.
Yeah.
And so I'll be like at a game store, like, oh, I remember playing this. I'm gonna buy it just to hear that crappy music again and see if I can beat it alone.
Yeah, and of course, we're talking about the gameplay, not necessarily collectors. We're talking right. about, like, is the gameplay worth it? And for me, honestly, $5, I think it's actually almost kind of worth it. Do not go over $5 for me. But it's like, it's a good long game, it's a fun game, and it's frustrating. And if you want to beat it, I mean, you're going to have to really memorize and put a lot of time into it.
Yeah.
And it's like, look at all the time we put into it, and it would have only cost us $5 to play that.
Yeah.
I mean, and there's so you can run around and find all sorts of stuff,
mm-hmm.
but do not go over $5 for it, unless, yeah. of course, you're a collector and you need it.
Yeah.
But the gameplay, do not pay over $5.
It's like, I kind of think you got to sit down and be like, I'm going to marathon this now.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to memorize everything, and I'm going to be able to teach people how to do it in the future.
Yeah. Because it definitely did get easier once we played it a lot more.
Uh-huh.
It was like, all of a sudden, I sit down. It took us forever to get up to World 7, and then all of a sudden, I sit down and get to World 7 within, like, 30 minutes.
Yeah.
But, whatever. Anyway, that was the 3D Battles of World Runner. Now, as far as putting in the game and just going, it should take only about 40 minutes to beat. But like I said, it's a game of big-time memorization, and it'll take you a long time. I think it took us, like, about 6 hours of gameplay to even beat it.
It takes quite a long time.
It's a toughie. It's definitely a doozy.
Once you get used to it, it does get easier.
And, of course, I don't know, Acclaim is part of it, and so is Square, which now is Squaresoft.
Yeah.
So, whatever. That was the 3D Battles of World Runner or 3D World Runner. Like I said, $5 if you see it. And you want it, maybe go and pick it up. Don't go over that, though.
Yeah.
So, whatever. That's it for that. So, whatever. I'm Janitor Jake.
I'm Chris K.
Thanks for watching.